All right, lesson 5.3, developing empathy and resilience. Okay. What skills do you need to develop empathy? You need to write those two words down, empathy and resilience. Okay, empathy and resilience. All right. Empathy and resilience. Okay. 30 seconds, write that down. Those are our key words, empathy and resilience. You don't need the whole sentence, you just need the two words, empathy and resilience. R-E-S-I-L-I-E-N-C-E. Okay. After studying this lesson, you will be able to identify the benefits of empathy. Take steps to become more empathetic. Explain the value of resilience and demonstrate skills to build resilience. Okay? Everybody read. You're going to give me an answer here in just a second. Okay. How can you respond to your friend? Negotiate and show that you care. Okay. Your friend sits with you at lunch having a hard day. Your friend's dog is really sick and might not make it through the day. And your friend cannot stop crying. You feel stressed since you and your friend had a plan on studying for the test the next period during lunch. How do you respond to this? Anybody? How do you respond to this? How do you respond? Mr. Ali, how do you respond? Okay, ask them if they're okay or do they need anything. That would be part of being empathetic, okay? What would you say? Mr. Ali says, I would ask them, do they need anything? What can I do? What body language would you use to get across your message? But remember, you and your friend had planned on studying for the test the next period during lunch. So now they've interrupted your plans. They've interrupted what you have going on, or what you need to have going on, rather, right? How would your response make your friend feel, okay? So using Mr. Ali's response, it would make that person, I guess, feel kind of good that they're asking, right? How would you feel after the conversation? Come on, freshman, this is your generation right here, empathy. Because why? Because your generation, everybody in your generation wants empathy. You don't know how I feel. You don't understand. Everybody in this generation wants somebody to understand how they feel. You need to be, I would think you would be more empathetic. Right? Not in my generation. We're pretty tough. We're pretty tough people. If you was born in the 70s like me, I know that's a long way for some of you. You're pretty tough, okay? All right, empathy, here we go. Ability to understand and share the feelings of another person, okay? Write that down. Ability to understand and share the feelings of another person, okay? Ability to understand, I want you to put a box around understand, and put a box around share. Okay? Those are two key words. Okay? Understand and share. Understanding is one thing. Understanding the situation means, I understand that your dog died. I'm sorry. When you share the same feeling, that means you had a dog die before and you understand from that perspective that I understand my dog died too. Okay? So you have cognitive empathy. You need that. The ability to see the world from another person's perspective. Then you have emotional empathy. The ability to experience the emotion another person is feeling. Again, here you can connect cognitive with understand. The cognitive is going to be the understand part. The emotional empathy is going to be the share. Okay? Emotional empathy is going to be the share. This is the word empathy. Okay, so let that sink in, what cognitive and emotional empathy and the difference. Okay, cognitive, I'm sorry, I stay in your way, sweetie. Cognitive and emotional differences. Cognitive and emotional differences. One minute. Remember, know the difference. Cognitive meaning understanding. Emotional meaning would relate to, not meaning, relate to sharing. Okay? Thirty seconds. Ready to go? Use your skill building empathy. Okay? Skill building empathy. Pay attention. You want to pay attention to that friend or that person that may be suffering from depression or that something like that. Okay? You want to listen well. Listen to people. Always listen to people. Let them talk. Okay, let them talk, get everything out, then respond. Okay? Value diversity. Okay? Read a book. I don't know what reading a book has to do with it, but okay. All right. Did you know resilience? People who experience difficult life circumstances often show high levels of resilience or ability to recover from stressful events. Okay? Experience some adversity gives people an opportunity to develop important skills for coping when future challenges arise. Okay, now, you can put that definition however you want on your paper. Okay, resilience is resilience. Most of you have resilience. I think I've asked this question before in here. How many of you parents in here, look up, were born in the United States? Exactly. Your parents are resilient. They came to another country and they came here and they managed to get food, clothes, and shelter on your backs while you go to school. That is resilient. So now you can't say a whole lot to your parents about what? Oh, I had a bad day. So what? You had a bad day. So what? Look at what they did. That is resilience. Being able to come back from something is resilience. Don't give up on something. Most of you, when you go to college, you're going to fail tests. That's just the way college works. You're going to fail test. You got a person that's giving you a test that's up here in their education, and you just got here. There's no way you're going to be able to understand what they're delivering in a short period of 3 or 4 weeks while you're there in your first, doing your first exam. You might come up to here. But the resilience of it is that you take it, analyze where you went wrong, go back, study harder, get study friends, go get other resources where you study. So now you make a better grade on the next test. That is a part of being resilient. Being able to overcome something. But if you quit, you're destined to fail, right? Okay? Use your skills building resilience, all right? Maintain relationships, okay? Relationships can be your support system, okay? Everybody needs some support sometimes, okay? Embrace change, okay? Embrace change. I have a hard time with that sometimes. I have a hard time embracing change. However, I pray about it and I move on. God usually puts me in a good position. I just don't know it yet, okay? Practice self-compassion. Okay. Sometimes, you know, you have to be a little, okay, it's okay. You know, compassionate on yourself. It's okay. All right. I messed up. Let me come back and do this a different way. Let me go a different direction. Okay. But at the top of that, the main umbrella is resilience. The main umbrella is resilience. Take responsibility. Now, if you screwed up, take responsibility of your screw up. If you go down to Mr. Wayne's class and you made a bad grade because you didn't study, don't blame Mr. Wayne. That's you. That's you. If you go to algebra and you don't pass the geometry and you didn't study, don't blame somebody else. That's you. That's on you. Well, he's not teaching right. No. The man's got a master's degree in math. He probably knows math. He probably knows math. I mean, you probably don't know it. Okay? All right, lesson review. Here we go. Which type of empathy is the ability to see the world from another person's perspective? Table two. Cognitive. What? Cognitive. Is he right? He's right. Very good. What is the ability to recover from a traumatic and stressful events? Table four. Resilience. She says resilience. Is it right? It is. What term describes an attitude of kindness and understanding toward oneself, even when experienced setbacks and disappointments? Who? Self-compassion. Just went over that. Remember, the key words is this. Oneself. Understanding kindness towards oneself. Okay? Whenever you see oneself, always put self-compassion. If you see the answer and it says self-compassion, anything that says self, the answer is self in it. I promise you. Okay? Write those down. Okay? Write those down. Cognitive empathy, resilience, and self-compassion. Now, self-compassion is cool, but don't stay down there too long. Okay? Sometimes you can stay down there too long, and now you start having a pity party. And that's never good. Okay? You have to be resilient. Look at your parents. I know you think your parents at this age don't know anything. But your parents came from another country, and they came here. They came from another country, not another state. Another country for where they don't even speak the language. The most gratifying thing you can do for them is be successful. That's the most they probably don't want anything from you. They probably, I'm not saying everybody. They probably don't want anything from you. They probably don't want, all they want you to do is be successful because that's what they came here for. They came here for you to have a better life. And when you don't take advantage of all the opportunities of having a better life, that is a complete slap in the face. So you remember that when you go to that English class and you want to fall asleep. You remember that when you go to that math class and you don't want to do the best you can. Remember that. You are slapping your parents in the face every time. Okay? All right, that is it for chapter 5. Remember, this is a B week. We will probably quiz over this on next Thursday. Okay? Next Thursday, yes, ma'am. Yeah. All right, next Thursday.
Yo. I go by the name, I'm Pharrell, from the Neptunes. And I